I am Marjolein Weemans. I'm working for the company Aquafin, and I would like to tell you something about the approach in Flanders. I'll first tell you a little bit about the company that I work for. Aquafin is the company that is in Flanders, northern part of Belgium, responsible for wastewater treatment and transport of wastewater. So that means that we have the task to finance, plan, design, operate and build the wastewater treatment plants, but also the transport system for transporting the wastewater and stormwater out of the municipalities. That means that we have about 320 wastewater treatment plants that we own and operate, and some 6,400 kilometers of sewers together with pumping stations and buffer basins. Now, as a company, we are not responsible, we are a private company, so we are not responsible for making up the policy on micropollutants that is in the hands of the Flemish Environment Agency, VMM, Vlaamse Milieumaatschappij. But of course, we do support them by means of our experience-based insights. Now, when it comes to micropollutants or when it comes to environmental legislation in general, this is translated into the VLAREM, it's the Flemish Environmental Regulation, and this contains a list of environmental quality standards for little bit more than 100 substances, in which also the priority pollutants are included and the river basin specific pollutants. And for the industrial emissions, this is regulated by means of source control, so they have in their permits specific requirements on the removal of these substances which are included in this list. But when it comes to municipal wastewater treatments, we do not have any regulation, not on these substances, not on other specific micropollutants. Of course, we do have regulations on COD and the conventional parameters. So that means that we are still in the beginning phase, the startup phase of making up an approach on how to deal with these micropollutants on wastewater treatment plants. And for that approach, we follow a three-track policy consisting of monitoring programs, of building up full-scale experience. We have one project in the pipeline at this moment, so not yet any full-scale plants operational. And then we have some research and development going on. I'll first tell you a little bit more about the monitoring programs. This has started already several years ago when the Environmental Agency started with the LIFE project WISE. WISE means Water Emission Inventory Support System. It's a kind of a model or a tool in which all kinds of inventories of pollutants, micropollutants, but also other pollutants are inventorized. And it also contains the transport routes and the spreading of the pollutants. So you can use it as a kind of a support tool to work on specific strategies to tackle specific pollutants. Then we have, in the continuation of this project, of this WISE project, there have been yearly programs on pharmaceuticals, for instance, and all these results have also been included into this WISE model. We also have a program on microplastics. I also include it here because to me it's also kind of a micropollutant. This is a monitoring program that has started last year. It's inventorizing not only wastewater treatment plants but also surface water, drinking water. But I will tell you a little bit more about that later on. And then as a company, we are involved in several projects. For instance, IDRIP, it's a project, I don't know if you know it, from the Joint Research Committee, which is inventorizing several micropollutants which are transported by sewer systems, so also drugs, for instance. Global Sewage Survey is another project in which we are delivering samples for monitoring. And then we have some R&D projects, not really focusing on monitoring, but because you do a lot of analysis there, they also collect data. Substances of relevance for us, of course, pharmaceuticals, but also nonylphenol and octylphenol are compounds that are very often still found in our effluents. A lot of pesticides, we treat a lot of stormwater, we have a lot of infiltration, so groundwater infiltrating into our sewer system, so these compounds are still found with high frequencies in the effluent of our wastewater treatment plants, as well as zinc, which is also a river basin-specific pollutant. The monitoring program on microplastics, this is initiated by the Flemish Environment Agency, started last year. They are monitoring surface waters, drinking waters, sludge and biota. and also 6 wastewater treatment plants. There they monitor both dry weather flow and wet weather flow, also the receiving surface water after this wastewater treatment plant by means of 24-hour composite samples, and all these analyses are then also put into this WISE model. We have installed a disk filter pilot plant that will also be monitored in the framework of this program, so for microplastics, where we will measure influent, effluent and backwash of the disk filter. So that's about the monitoring campaigns. Then the full-scale experience. As I said, we don't yet have any full-scale experience on advanced treatment for micropollutants. We have now one project in the pipeline. It's for the wastewater treatment plant of Aartselaar. That's a treatment plant located close to Antwerp, also very close to our headquarters. It's a 60,000 population equivalent treatment plant. And actually we have a lot of problems there with suspended solids because the settling tanks that you see there have a very big diameter, 45 meter diameter, so they show very frequent flushing of suspended solids. And we have already tried many remediations, dosing polymers and so on, but now we have decided to build disk filters over there to remove the suspended solids. And we thought that it would be a good idea to combine this with an advanced treatment, because if you have the disk filters, then you already get rid of the DOC. So an advanced treatment would be efficient there. And also, of course, the main driver, we urgently need to build up full-scale experience with this micropollutant removal. There is not yet any legislation on that in Flanders, but there clearly is a high pressure also from Europe that we need to do something about this and that we need to build up experience. So that's why we have proposed this project, and this has a little bit to do with the way that we are financed. If we want to build a project, we first have to get the approval of the government. We have to make a proposal with kind of budget estimation, and then they can approve or disapprove. And once they approve, we can go on with the design and the tendering. Now, this kind of project is, of course, unique in its context, because it's out of the scope of the current legislation. So we had to do a lot of consultation with the government, with the Flemish Environmental Agency, to get this kind of project approved. But now it is finally approved. And the main consultation, of course, was about how are we going to design this? What needs to be the design capacity of such a plant? Because for all our regular wastewater treatment plants, we design at a flow of 6 times the dry weather flow. But is this really necessary for an advanced treatment? Can't you have a design for a lower flow? So that was one of the discussions that we had to deal with. Also, of course, the micropollutant selection. Since it's not involved in legislation, which parameters are we going to monitor? How are we going to evaluate this plant? Which technology are we going to apply? And do we need pilot scale research before building a full scale plant, or are we going directly for the full scale plant? We decided to go directly for the full scale plant because there is already a lot of experience available in what we've heard before, and we thought that we could as well use this experience and go immediately for the full scale plant. The pollutants that we target is still, of course, a point of discussion. We have done an analysis on all the data that we have, and we decided that for this first plant, we would monitor a long list to get more information on that, and that long list is based on the database that we have. All compounds that we find there in frequencies higher than 25% of the samples are taken up in this list, together with all the compounds that are found on this particular wastewater treatment plant at a concentration higher than the detection level. So this is then finally the list. I think a lot of compounds look familiar to you. This is the list that we are going to monitor in this particular project. Of course, for future, we have to make a more condensed list on parameters that are going to be used as an evaluation. Design capacity. As I said, our wastewater treatment plants treat 6 times the dry weather flow. Q14 means dry weather flow. For the disk filter, we decided that we would treat half of this maximum flow rate, so 3 times the dry weather flow. And for the advanced treatment, we would design at 2 times the dry weather flow, and that then covers 75% of the yearly flow. This is the flow distribution that you see here. So the blue line is the advanced treatment. It will be designed at 1,200 cubic meters per hour. So it covers most of the flow during the year, and the disc filter will cover almost everything. That will be designed at 2,000 cubic meters a year. Technology is mainly based on literature survey technology selection. We decided to go after the disc filters for ozone combined with granular activated carbon because we thought that that would be the safest solution, conquering both pollutants by ozone and their transformation products by the activated carbon. This is how it will be implemented. By the way, one other specific reason why we have chosen this particular plant was not only because we are building disc filters there, but also because, as you can see, the surface water in which we are discharging is quite a small brook, I would say. So this wastewater treatment plant has a high impact on this grote Struisbeek. Implementation, we do not have that much space. Is this a pointer? This is the area in which we can build. So everything that you see here is not our property. So we have to stick in this, this area, so very limited space. The granular activated carbon will be positioned there, right next to the settling tanks, the disc filters next to that, the ozone contact tank and the ozone generator. But as you can see, it will be very cropped and a difficult project to realize. For the costs, the indicative costs, we have based ourselves upon the figures from STOA in our original budget estimation. But in the meantime, we have a more detailed estimation based on our own prices that we have in databases. And the estimation for the capex cost for this plant, so disc filters together with ozone and activated carbon, is 4.9 million euros. And the OPEX costs are estimated at 330,000 euros per year. But this is exclusive. This is excluding the costs for the analysis. So we don't know yet which analysis we will focus on in a more structured way. If you calculate it as euro per cubic meter, we end up at around 7 cents per cubic meter, which is in the order, I think, of the German figures, of the Swiss figures, a little bit lower than the Dutch figures, but I think also in our wastewater treatment plants, we see big differences between Belgium and the Netherlands. One of the main goals of this project is, of course, to get a better view on the costs, because that will be the basis for the further approach within Flanders and how we are going to roll out, or how our environmental agency thinks about it, about rolling out this advanced treatment. So the project will need to give us a better view on the lifetime of the granular activated carbon and on the optimal dosing. An additional study that we are doing is whether we can have some additional benefits. We are now treating this water to a higher standard. Does this mean that we have some opportunities towards reuse? We have some companies, for instance, industry close to the wastewater treatment plant. So that might be an opportunity, and see if we can find a synergy there. How is this financed? As I said before, the Flemish government is assigning the investment projects to us upon our proposal, but the obligation to treat wastewater, that is given to the drinking water companies. These drinking water companies have made an agreement with Aquafin, so Aquafin is doing this obligation for them. We are sending them our invoice several times a year. And the drinking water companies are then collecting the money either from the citizens by means of the water bill. So this water bill contains a price for the drinking water itself, and it contains a price for the transport in the municipality, and a price for transport and treatment by Aquafin. About 70% of what the citizen pays is covering our invoice. The rest of it is collected by funding from the government, the so-called MINA fund, which is getting its funding from taxes. So this is how our regular wastewater treatment within Flanders is financed. And this particular project on micropollutants is actually financed in exactly the same way. So that means if we are going to build more projects like that, that either we will do less conventional projects, or the water bill for the citizens will have to rise. But I think it will be more on doing less of the conventional projects. Source control, I can be short about that. Everyone agrees that this is sustainable and intrinsically safer than end-of-pipe solutions, but there is not too much going on in Flanders. Our environmental agency indicates that it's very complex for them because of the dispersed competences. There are a lot of ideas, but not too much is been going on that field. A few more words about research and development. First important thing is the site that we are going to build in Aartselaar will be open for testing. What you didn't see on the picture, or what I didn't show on the picture, is that we have a big research hall over there. So companies or universities that are developing new technologies can come and test it over there, and they can then compare it to the, or benchmark it to the, let's say, conventional treatment technologies. Same for control algorithms. University of Ghent is doing a lot of work on ozone dose control strategies, can be tested over there. And also the effect-related testing, where University of Antwerp has a lot of experience and projects going on, will be done on this site. So it will also be a research site. We have been involved in several projects on micropollutant removal. We have now just finished one. We do have some other projects in the pipeline, but not yet approved. So I'll just tell you about this one. It's a three-track project, a Marie Curie project, in which we have evaluated a technology which is combining biological activated carbon filtration together with membrane filtration. We saw good removal over there, as could be expected, but what we also saw was that there was a significant contribution of the biology on the activated carbon, especially for those six compounds which were removed at much higher efficiency when we compared it to the abiotic granular activated carbon. We did not select this technology for the case of Aartselaar, mainly because of costs, also a lack of full-scale experience. But it could be an interesting alternative in, for instance, specific reuse projects, because you have the membranes over there. Another thing, a PhD that was also done in the framework of this three-track project, is a PhD about a decision support tool. It was elaborated here for diclofenac and on the Damer Basin. That's a basin, river basin, in the eastern part of Flanders. And this model contained a wastewater treatment plant model and a river model. And it had an optimization function. It also included a lot of data and models about diclofenac removal efficiency and costs. And then there was an optimization function that optimized towards grams of diclofenac removed versus the investment that you wanted to do there. I think the main message out of this study was that if you want to optimize, it's not always the best approach to just go for the big wastewater treatment plants. If you want to optimize towards cost, you might make other choices. I'm not saying that this is the optimal approach, just saying that there is a difference in the way you can approach this, or you can select your wastewater treatment plants for advanced treatment. It could be a basis for a further rollout, but as you can see, we still have very much work to do. We are now focusing on this one particular plant, and we hope that the course of the years others will follow, and that we will come to a more structured approach for micropollutant removal in Flanders. That was my story. Thank you very much.